take the gun. Oh, shit, leave the gun. He might get past you. I don't want that son of a bitch getting me. Getting me like he's going to break in the house and go, get it, get it. Hold me down, tickle the shit out of me. Cops show up, what happened? He tickled me. I peed my pants. He pulled my underwear up my butt and left. You catch that bastard, he's dangerous. All the time, I don't see my wife. 40 weeks, I'm a horny son of a bitch. Stay that way, I got a little chub working right now. My wife does. She misses it, too. She called me the other about 6 weeks ago, crying. I miss you, and I need it. Well, I need it, too, but it don't reach that far. I wish it did. If I could take it off, put it on a plane, I'd send it to you. Wouldn't that be funny? Little wiener sitting up there in first class. How you doing? Pretty good. She likes some nuts? I already got some. So I bought her a little fake wiener to play with while I was gone, which was a huge mistake, because I don't even see her when I'm home now. Oh, yeah. She's locked up in the bedroom. Sound like somebody's landscaping in there. Honey, are you all right? Yeah, my neck hurts. Your neck's been hurting an awful lot lately. It's the most embarrassing thing you'll ever have to shop for as a man as long as you live. I never thought in a million years to ever say, I'm going to go look for a weenie. I'll be back. Walked in this place, Christie's Toy Box, Tulsa, Oklahoma. I was dressed in an overcoat, fake beard, mustache. Figure if I'm going to mingle with these perverts, better look like one. Oh, fuck, I'm a pervert. Took the coat off, stood there naked. The guy walked up to me, said, can I help you? I said, my wife needs a weenie. He said, I can see that. So I slapped the shit out of it. He said, what do you think about that bacon up there at the top on the shelf there? I said, holy shit, that's a big son of a bitch. I don't want to compete with that damn thing. I wanted her to leave me up by that. There ought to be a law where they don't make them things over 4 or 5 inches long. That humming shit, we can't compete. You can't put a motor in your wiener to an acid doctor. Can't be done. He pulled one off the shelf. He said, this one looks real and it feels real. Touch it. He said, this is a popular model. I said, I ain't buying a car, jackass. Just need a wiener. He convinced me that was the one, and I went to pay for it. He said, that'll be $57 and some change. I said, that better be some damn good wiener. Better make sure you got enough money, too. You think being at the grocery store and having to put back beans is embarrassing? You got to put back a wiener, you're going to wish you had a hole to crawl off into. People standing behind you. Pay for your weenie, get the hell out of here. Don't put it on your charge, they'll call you. Did you buy a weenie? You pay cash, you burn the receipt, and take the back roads home. Not my dumb ass, I took the interstate. Got pulled over. Let me see your license and what's in that sack. I'm not sure I stole this truck. You got kids and you're thinking about having them go to Chuck E. Cheese on Saturday. By God, you'll leave her and go buy you a dog. I ain't shitting you. Thank God they sell beer in that damn place. I saw old boy get drunk and beat the hell out of that gorilla up there singing. He couldn't take that shit. He ripped his head off, kicked that piano, right through his ass out. Don't you ever come back to Chucky's, you son of a bitch. Do you know how bad you gotta fuck up to get banned from Chucky's? Pretty damn bad. I hate that place. The only thing I like about it is Skibo. The only reason I like that is because I'm damn good at it. Got my own balls and a little carrying case. Got my name on the side, Skibo champion. You're jealous as hell, I can feel it. Skee-ball's that game you play where you, you know, get all them tickets, you go redeem them for prizes, you end up spending about $1,900 for a whistle. You spend all day in there racking up on tickets. You got your 80,000 tickets. You cop an attitude walking up to that price counter. I think they're going to have to run out to the truck and get some more shit for Daddy. All right, here's all my tickets. Let's start with a whistle. Okay, you got two left. Shit, give me a spider ring in.
Stopped off on the way up there at some Japanese, Chinese, fuck, they all look alike restaurants. Someplace called Poontang. You been there? Shit, I liked it. Hell, I ordered it.
You want Poontang? Good choice, cowboy.
It's one of them places where they come out and cook in front of you, you know? Ah, cha 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 cha. The problem was, some jackass hillbilly like me showed up to cook. What the fuck happened here? Did Ching Lee get sick? What are you doing out here? You don't want to go to Disney World and have Chuck E. Cheese filling in for Mickey Mouse. You want the real shit. I want a Japanese guy. Guy comes out, ah, throws a knife, kills the guy next to him. He don't walk here no more. Well, no shit, Kung Fu. He just killed the son of a bitch. I think we ought to have restaurants over in Japan where we cook in front of them our way, you know? Four lawn chairs, a grill. Some big old cowboy cooking. What's it gonna be, Chinky? Hot dog or a hamburger? I know a lot of you just went, he said, Chinky, get your purse. He's making fun of Chinese people. That's right, I got two words for you. Fuck you. Let me tell you why. Every one of you people in here make fun of Chinese people. That's why they're in this country, for our entertainment pleasure. Ever walk in a Chinese food restaurant and look around? Everybody in there is laughing and snickering at one point. The old boy walks up to you. Where you want to sit? Well, goddamn, could you talk any faster? Ain't like you got shit to do. It's a buffet, for God's sakes. What you want to eat? Well, goddamn, let me sit down first, you overachiever. Back up a little bit. We're going to have that Mugu Gapan, because that's the only thing we know how to pronounce. Steam rice and a sweet tea, chop chop. He walks away from my table. I can't help myself. Hell, I got my kids doing it. He came back to the table. He was pissed. He says, you make fun of me, cowboy. Well, I was all flustered. I said, I don't make fun of you. Well, I'll be damned if I didn't get caught. I don't give a shit. Hell, I like... Excuse me, was I talking while you were over? Comedy show, lights, microphone. Fuck me, what an asshole. Shut up. Listen. What the fuck? You people just hollering shit out like this is a Jerry Springer show. Keep your fucking mouth shut. Trying to talk to you people. I ain't gonna come to where you work, throw rocks at you when you fucking mowing, so shut up. I love that old fucker. He come up to the house this summer. We took the kids to Disney World for the second year in a row. It's about a 40-day ride in a truck from where I live. Time you get there, he's pissed off at your entire family for being in the car that long. You just want to fucking kill them. Throw them in a river and drive back to the house. Spend $3,000 to get in, stood in line for 14 hours and rode three rides. Then you got that 40-mile walk back to the minivan. You're wearing a set of Mickey Mouse ears. They're on crooked. Got a horrible sunburn carrying an 85-pound Winnie the Pooh you won 9 hours ago at a fucking softball throw. Goddamn, this was a good idea, wasn't it? You don't even know where you parked anymore. The kids are all cotton candied up. Cuckoo, cuckoo, shut up! You get in the tram, they'll ask you, where'd you park? Fuck it, just take us home. Where do you live? Oklahoma, jackass. Get to traffic. Just get pissed. You been on that ride, Small World? It's a small world after all. It's a small world. It's a small... Fuck, shoot me! That is the longest ride in amusement park history. I'd like to find Walt Disney, dig his ass up, kick him in the nuts, and ask him, what the fuck were you thinking when you built that son of a bitch? It's not even fun, Walt. You're on a boat with 30 people. It just stink to high heaven because they've been in the sun as long as you have. You're just looking for a light at the end of the tunnel. Fuck it, I'm sweating. It's the same shit, same elves singing the same song over and over again. Put two elves on a log naked doing something nasty. Make daddy happy. They need more adult-themed rides in that park for us horny people. Take the log ride. Make it the big pecker ride. Big old pecker floating in the water. Put six guys in it and send it up Titty Mountain. Down Titty Mountain. Rub the nipple as you go by. Right into a big old push. Just... I'm not talking about a clean-shaven little Hitler mustache manicured puss. I hate those. It's a garden, woman. Let it grow. God gave it to you. I'm talking about a 1970s all-natural buckwheat on a bad hair day puss. I want to come over the top of Titty Mountain and know daddy's going in something wrong. Hold on, boys. We're going in the puss. Ah! Shit, is it dark in here? Good Lord, I'm wet. You smell that? What is that?
Shit, I worry about dying. I'm a hypochondriac. I mean to tell you, if I stump my toe, I got cancer. That's how serious it is. Ain't nothing funny about that. I bought a medical dictionary. I read through that some bitch. I got shit I didn't know I had. I got rickets. What the fuck is that? I went in for a physical a month ago. The doctor called me before I came in. He says, I want you to bring me a stool sample. So I shit the shoebox and I took it in there to him. He said, good God, all I needed was a sample. I said, well, get what you need and make a figurine out of the rest. I ain't playing in that. You want to get pissy? I could have brought three of them in here on a stringer. What do you think about that? You should have seen the one that got away. It broke the net. See, this hypochondriac shit started about a year ago. I came home, I had this pain in my side. I told my wife, I go, God damn it, this is it. She said, what? I said, I'm dying. I got cancer. She said, you ain't got cancer. I said, bullshit. It ain't a tummy ache. It's over here. It's fucking cancer. I went to the doctor. I said, what is this? He said, that's where your liver and your gallbladder is. I went, shit, I got cancer. He says, you ain't got cancer. I said, you sure? He said, no. Fuck. Don't tell me that. He said, quit worrying. We'll do an ultrasound. I said, I'm not pregnant. I must have cancer. He says, we'll do it in a couple of days. No! Fuck! I could be dead in a couple of days. This shit's growing at a rapid pace. I'm starting to notice shit I've never noticed, like wind and flowers and trees. I'm talking to bugs. Hey, little fella, I'm a fucking basket case! So I go in for this ultrasound. I got my shirt off and my pants off for some damn reason. This lady's fiddling around with my wiener. And it dawned on me, I was in the wrong fucking place. Hell, I was at a geisha girl joint a block away. And I enjoyed the shit out of myself. The next day, I went in for this ultrasound. I had my shirt off, and this lady's scanning me, and I'm crying like a four-year-old who just shit his pants on the playground. She says, how long have you had this? I went, for the love of God, what the fuck do you see? She said, nothing, let go of my titties. I mean to tell you, if I was going, she was going with me. Then I had to go through a CAT scan. That's where they lay you down, slide you through a tube. Look at all your insides. But before they do, they make you drink this barium milkshake, which, by the way, is delicious. They're $8,000 a piece, too. Wait till you get the bill. I drank mine too fast. I had to drink another one when I got in there. Overachiever. I'm getting there, jackass. Settle down. I got to tell you, that lady slid me through the tube and slid me back out. She said, everything looks good. We got to check your prostate gland. I said, well, you can flip me over and slide me back through there. I got all damn day. She said, oh, no. Woo, 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 woo. I said, horse shit, I don't like no woo, 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 woo. Well, about an hour later, I didn't have much of a choice. I was in the doctor's office with Dr. Woo Woo. He's a Japanese fella, about 3 feet tall. Thank God you don't want some big 6'8" son bitch. Come on in here.
Fuck you.
Oh. You take that Super Bowl ring off, we'll talk. He'll tell you when you get in there. Bend over.